confront those issues in the way that the public service works with a new government to achieve great results while being accountable. What are the key issues facing us today in Nigeria? I think that first and foremost, we have to realize that the era of sharing money is gone. This business, I get from bank account, I sit down on my bag, I give a few friends of mine contracts, and they say there's no money, can't even pay salaries. That's gone. We need to begin to train and retrain the public service to understand where the political actors are standing and what they want to accomplish, and it is possible to make them partners in that process without spoiling the so-called neutrality of the service. You got to find the breast of civil servants, train them well, get them to get things done on the boots, the straps of their boots. That way, our country will make progress. OGUN will make progress.
Sequel to the electoral victory, three major steps have been taken as part of the preparations of the incoming administration to match action with words in determination to realize the mission to provide good governance. First, we set up an economic transition committee and work group to further elaborate on the building our future together agenda and provide a roadmap that identifies specific initiatives and timelines in buckets of 100 days, short, medium term, and long term. A few elements are unique about our transition team. They are a blend of expertise of technocrats and the local knowledge and nuances of the environment provided by our political class. In addition, we invited other major political parties and co-contestants for the gubernatorial seat to ensure inclusiveness and an enriched process. I'm delighted to note that the preliminary report of the work about a week ago has confirmed my belief in the knowledge, in belief that the knowledge, wisdom, and even passion to achieve good governance are in abundance across the state and party lines. I will submit myself to the people. To the will of the people. I will invest in human capital. I will remain humble. If it has gotten me this far, I don't have any reason to change. Let me assure you that we will carefully study and distill the conclusions of today's conversation and synergize them with other submissions such as the work group reports and various inputs of stakeholders. Furthermore, this type of gathering will be a regular feature of our administration, during which we hope to report back to the citizens, measure progress, treat where necessary, and build a new momentum for our building our future together agenda.